Hello and welcome to 4A's Tech. This is Dell's Inspiron 5570, featuring the most commonly used Core i7-8550U processor. 4.7 pounds of the chassis is made of polycarbonate plastic, which indicates clearly why it should fall into a very budget range of laptops. It comes in black and silver. I like the silver since it's a little less boring. It's a simple matte looking design on the exterior and a brushed aluminium panel around the keyboard and touch area inside. It does get a lot of smudges. Opening the lid is a long hinge which is strong enough to keep the screen from wobbling. Screen doesn't bend at all, which is good, and the overall deck is reasonably strong. The keyboard, it's low travel, no tactile feel to it. Good thing is it's backlit and has a numpad. The touchpad is noisy even to the lightest tap. Multi-tap gestures work fine, but overall feel of the touchpad is very nominal, which is why I preferred using my mouse. At the bottom we have the vent. The two speakers just below the front end of the laptop. Reaching internals is simple with the screws at the bottom. Inside we have the 2.5 inch 2TB Seagate hard drive along with M.2 SSD slot. Now there are 8 gigs of RAM in this and can be extended up to 32 gigs. Now the display, it's a 15.6 inch TN Full HD panel. Since it's a TN panel, so not very accurate at colors or contrast, and the viewing angles are very average. So at this price point, Dell should have placed a better IPS display to make it a compelling deal. For graphics, we have a UHD 620 Intel along with Radeon 530 with 4 gigs of video memory, which went decently playing GTA 5 on an average of 58 FPS and Shadow of Warrior on normal settings, giving around 33 to 35 FPS. Now here, pause the sound and video. Dell, this is for you. If you don't already know, there are a lot of complaints regarding 100% disk usage in the laptops that usually come without the SSD. Now kindly do something about it, as it makes the entire laptop a beautiful slab of waste and nothing else for someone who is either buying it for studies or work. Since not everyone is nerd enough to buy a new laptop to spend next 3 days trying to figure out this error. So my humble request is, get it fixed. A new laptop should be at its best right out of the box. So if you guys have faced this issue with your laptops, which I did, then I'm leaving a few links in the description. There are tons of videos to get this fixed. Run the music and let's continue. The Geekbench and Cinebench scores are pretty good, which is what I was expecting. So the Max Audio Pro sound on this laptop is definitely impressive. Both high and low frequencies sound decent and mids are well balanced. Good thing is, there's a reasonable base to enjoy more songs and even movies. Make sure to keep the area in the front of the laptop clear though. Another good thing is the number of ports that comes with this laptop. So we've got the AC jack, got the USB-C port, the HDMI, Ethernet, two USB 3.0 and audio jack. On the right we have the DVD rewriter, USB 2.0 and SD card reader. On the top we have an average 720p camera. Now the 3 cell 42 watt hour battery on battery saver gave me around 3.5 hours on light and 2.5 hours on medium usage. The temperatures remained at 46 degrees on light and remained around 68 degrees on medium to intense usage. Now besides the hard drive issue, the laptop performed quite well. There were no lags, surfing, office and multitasking has been reasonably good. Games ran fine and didn't cause any glitch as such in launch or switching. So to wrap up, the laptop, it looks good, has a decent processor, lots of storage to choose from, 4 gigs of video RAM, lots of ports, a DVD drive and a good sound. But for me, the serious deal breakers is mainly the hard disk usage problem, then the screen, and then the battery. I was expecting a bit more battery than this. So that was the Dell 5570 Inspiron. Hope you guys liked the review, hit like and subscribe for future reviews. Till again, 4A's Tech, signing out.